Hello everyone, we BSc Nutrition final year students are here to make a presentation on food spoilage. Food spoilage is a known vast domain to be discussed, and as we know, the most natural foods have a limited lifespan. Once the food has been harvested, gathered or slaughtered, it begins to deteriorate and eventually it becomes unfit for human consumption. This deterioration is known as decay and it leads to food spoilage. Now let's move on to the technical definition, which says food spoilage can be defined as decay or decomposition of undesirable nature of foods. These changes may cause the food to lose its nutritive value or to become unpleasant or unfit for human consumption, or even positively harmful to the consumers. These changes are collectively referred to as food spoilage. Moving on to the classification of foods based upon its stability. Foods are classified into three groups based on the ease of their spoilage: perishable foods, semi-perishable foods, and non-perishable foods. Perishable foods includes the foods that spoil readily unless special preservative methods are used. This includes most of our daily foods such as milk, meat, egg, fish, poultry, fruits and vegetables, especially green leafy vegetables. Semi-perishable foods. Foods that remain unspoiled for a fairly long period of time if properly handled and stored. Examples: potatoes, apples, onions, etc. Non-perishable foods. Foods that do not spoil unless handled carefully. Example: grains, flours, sugars, pulses, etc. Well, while talking about the food spoilage, we should also know what are the agents that causes food spoilage. These agents are broadly classified into three terms: physical spoilage, chemical spoilage, and microbial spoilage. Physical spoilage includes mechanical damage and damage by rodents and pests. Chemical spoilage includes chemical contamination, rancidity, enzymatic and non-enzymatic reactions. Microbial spoilage includes spoilage due to bacteria, yeast, and molds. Physical spoilage can be further classified into spoilage due to mechanical damage. After harvesting, the food may undergo a lot of handling and dealing, which may result in a number of changes in the food in its appearance or outer covering. Example: fruits, vegetables and nuts, which has an outer covering which protects them from any damages, causes the entry of microorganisms into the food, which spoils it. Spoilage due to pests and rodents. Worms, bugs, fruit flies, moths causes extensive damage to food and reduces its nutritional value and make it unfit for human consumption. Pests and rodents can damage the food in two ways: direct damage by directly eating away the food, and by indirect damage by contaminating it with rat droppings, excreta, urine, leading to the production of disease-causing toxins, which ultimately leads to food spoilage. Chemical spoilage. This domain includes spoilage due to chemical contamination, rancidity, enzymatic browning and non-enzymatic browning reactions. Chemical contamination includes pesticides and fertilizers which are used to increase the food production. The excess residues remains in the soil and in the environment even after harvesting it. To overcome this spoilage, use of biodegradable pesticides and natural fertilizers should be encouraged. Rancidity. The term rancid means to spoil or decompose, and this spoilage occurs in lipids when the fats and oils are exposed to heat, light, air, moisture, etc. Rancidity can be classified into three main types: hydrolytic rancidity, which is due to splitting of fats by water, which produces fatty acid chain and glycerol. Oxidative rancidity occurs when the storage is not proper and it leads to cleavage of double bonds of unsaturated fatty acids caused through oxidation degradation in air. A peculiar change in the smell and flavor is seen. Microbial rancidity is breaking of fats using the enzymes of microorganisms such as lipase. This makes the food to change, ultimately leading to food spoilage. Enzymatic browning reaction. This occurs in most of the fruits and vegetables like potatoes, brinjals, apple, banana, etc. When they are cut and kept open, exposure to air in turns black or brown in color. Polyphenol oxidase is the enzyme which acts upon the tyrosine, which is an amino acid, which gets converted to orthoquinone to form brown pigment. Non-enzymatic browning reaction. In this process, also the browning pigmentation of the foods occurs, but without the enzyme activity. It occurs in two forms, which is caramelization, involves pyrolysis of sugars, and Maillard reaction, when foods get heated up. Food spoilage due to microbes, that is microbial contamination or spoilage. Microorganisms has the ability of contamination of foods. The main microorganisms responsible for the foods are bacteria, molds, yeast, etc. These microorganisms are invisible to the naked eyes but can be seen under a microscope. They are capable of multiplying very rapidly in the correct moisture, food and temperature conditions that are the optimum temperatures for their growth. These conditions must be avoided if the risk of the food spoilage is to be reduced. This food starts smelling awfully and it leads to spoilage. Let's now look at each of these microorganisms and how they operate. Molds. It is in the form of thread developed on a perishable foods which are easily visible to the eyes. They appear to be cottony, spongy and they grow from cells called spores present in the air. Most of the molds are not harmful. Yeast. These are anaerobic microorganisms which are not visible to the naked eyes but can be seen through microscope. Yeast are responsible for the food spoilage in high sugar foods such as fruits, jams, etc. They are useful microorganisms such as used in yeast fermentation to produce cheese, breads, alcoholic beverages, etc. Bacteria. Bacteria are the most widespread microorganisms found in the food. They are minute single cells and of various shapes. The one with spherical are called as cocci and the one with cylindrical or rod shape are called as bacilli and the one with spiral or fibrous are called as spiral bacteria. This is the classification of bacteria based on their structures. Whereas they are active over a wide range of temperatures which can be classified in as cyclophytes, cold-loving bacteria which grows in 10 degrees to 15 degrees Celsius, also in 5 degrees Celsius. Mesophytes, the bacteria that grows in room temperatures are called mesophytes. Thermophytes, higher temperatures, that is 5 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius. Example, in canning industries, in milk processing plants, etc. Factors determining the stability of foods. pH. Foods with neutral pH get spoiled faster as the microorganisms grow faster in the neutral medium. To prevent this, the foodstuff can be made stable by altering the pH. Example, by addition of salts, acids, etc. Available water, also called as active water or free water. To give a better understanding to this, as all the foods contain water, which can be of two types. Bound water and available water. And available water is the one which does not go into the composition and structure of the foods, which is readily available for the microorganisms to grow. Therefore, more the value of available water of the foods, lesser is the stability. Temperature. Room temperature causes spoilage of the food. Either the food has to be kept at high temperature or at low temperature to increase its stability. Oxygen. On daily basis, we have seen that foods when kept outside tends to get spoiled. Therefore, more the oxygen available in the vicinity, more the food loses its stability. Nutrients. The nutrient content of the food. Protein-rich food like eggs, fish, meat gets spoiled faster than the other groups of the food. Extra precautions are to be taken to increase the shelf life of the foods. By now, I hope you understand what is food spoilage and how do we classify them on the ease of its stability. Also, the factors and agents that causes food spoilage. Well, this brings me to the end of my presentation. Thank you for all the attention.